Radio. Shout it.
I mean, speaking of being around geniuses, though, man, Stevie, Teddy P, man, yeah. Getting the game from the real James Brown. OGs, James yeah. Brown. I mean, tell me, what was that like, and what did they lay on you, man?
They blessed me, man. I feel like they anointed me, man, in church speaking, man. I met Teddy P, not in the studio, not on stage. I met him in his house, you know, in Philadelphia. And that was a pretty crazy experience. Mm-hmm. Dram Fidel took me over there, two Grammy Award winning producers. Mm-hmm. And it was just like I was initiated into the Mafia. This is the R&B Soul Mafia for the first time. Just to give you a brief, like just a couple questions he asked me. He said, "So you sing, huh?" Yeah, sir. You know, I sing. Who you sound like? Nobody really. That's what I want to hear. Like yeah. it was like trick questions to test me. Yeah. He was really checking me, like, you know what I mean? Like, you know, seeing where I was at, seeing who they brought in the dough.
Exactly.
And it was like a weird but surreal but very truthful. Like, to somebody that understand mob movies and stuff like that, you understand that moment.
Mm-hmm.
And that's kind of what it was. And that was Teddy P. Yeah. Meeting James Brown was pretty crazy. I was rocking with Usher. Shout out to Usher.
Yeah.
I was rocking with Usher at the time, and we was doing a Confessions tour.
Yeah.
And we had a chance to rock at the Grammys,
mm-hmm.
and we was going to do Caught Up, but they was mixing Caught Up with Get On Up with James Brown.
Mm-hmm.
And it's crazy, that's the name of the movie, too. Rest in peace, JB.
Yeah.
But, yeah, so it was just so crazy. Number one, you had to call him Mr. Brown, you know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
His name is Mr. Brown.
That's right.
Don't give a care who you is, where you from. Call that man Mr. Brown. How old you is, whoever, if you had parents or not, Mr. Brown. The cats and dogs called him Mr. Brown. So it was just so surreal to even have him give me my note to sing in the song that we was doing on the Grammys, or to see him walk in and actually see James Brown.
Yeah.
You don't it wasn't like he came in with sweats on and
now
he was hard bottoms,
exactly.
Slacks, button up, four buttons unbuttoned, couple gold chains on, rings on,
yeah.
Thick cologne, smell like a preacher, hair done, makeup on, smelling like just James Brown.
That's right.
They say, Boosie say, man, when you come out of the house, man, they pay to see Boosie. So every time they see me, I'm gonna have these glasses on, I'm gonna have this hat on,
that's
whether
right.
it's a sweatsuit or a real suit.
That's right.
They pay to see Boosie. And I understand that mindset. You're an entertainer, man.
Yeah.
And when you have something that's in demand like that, you have to supply.
Mm-hmm.
And otherwise, what are you?
Mm-hmm.
You know? What are you serving? Who are you serving? What's going on?
That's right.
So I kind of understand it, but it was just a blessing, man, work with James Brown on the Grammys, with Usher, during Confessions, probably one of the highest R&B selling albums of all time, under Mike Jack. Like, it's just, it's insane, man.
I mean, being with Usher on that Confessions tour, man, I mean, I know he had to lay some game on you too, man, because that Confessions was just stupid.
Usher's a big brother, man.
Yeah.
We don't talk all the time, but we talk more often than people would really think.
Uh-huh.
And, man, I appreciate his words of wisdom. And he, some people, like, you know, man, you know, they become a big brother. He, like, he receives being a big brother to us younger guys, and just helping make sure that we keep a level head, man. That's big, because, like, in my life, that's how I got through, having an OG, having a big brother. Not even if it's my blood big brother, somebody who you could throw a ball off the wall to, man.
Exactly.
They, like, you know, I probably wouldn't do that, but, you know, I'd do this.
Mm-hmm.
Or just telling you, nah, don't do this, do this. Sometimes you need to hear that, man.
Yeah.
You gotta humble yourself to somebody, man, otherwise you're gonna bump your head harder than others.
Yeah.
We all gonna bump our head for sure.
Exactly.
But, like, if you ain't got nobody to kind of help you, man, and just, you know, keep your head level, man, I suggest you do it.
Radio Shouting.